Yeah, so first I'm going to warm up with a few lightweight exercises for my shoulders before I get into my working sets. I normally do around one working set per exercise, but I feel like I've accommodated to what I've been doing, so I'm going to sort of add a little bit more volume and decrease the intensity a little bit for a few weeks, and then I'll go back to my normal one set per body part. I also wear a heart rate monitor when I train, so you can always see your intensities when you're training, so I always want to try to get down to zone 2 or zone 1 before I do my next set. So around 115, 120 is what I try to look for before I do my next set, so I'm recovered before I initiate the next one. I like to do they're called controlled articular rotations, or CARs. What they are is a display of the range of motion that you have, and it just helps warm up your joint prior to exercise. You want to put your feet shoulder width apart. You want to squeeze your glutes. Try to maintain spinal extension a little bit. You don't want to twist as you take your arm. You want to try to maintain everything straight. So you want to externally rotate. You want to pull up through your front belt until you hit in range. And then you're going to rotate through your shoulder, not your wrist, and you want to reach back as far as you can, rotating through your shoulder. Then you want to go back into extension, bring it up, and rotate all the way back around. All right, so this next exercise is called the Bradford Press. Louis Simmons, when I was at Westside Barbell, I did a podcast a few years ago. He says, with this exercise, you have massive shoulders. So I was like, well, I might as well do this exercise because I need bigger shoulders. So I'll show you how to do this exercise. Basically, what you're doing is you're going to have the bar right here, and you're going to bring it slightly over your head and slightly back and forth. So you're not pressing it all the way up. It's just like this motion. You don't need tons of weight. I might go up to 135. For a set of like 12 or 15, it's going to blow up your shoulders. I love life, I love hip-hop, and it don't stop. A 1-2-1-2, it's lyrics touch your soul. I love life, I love hip-hop, and it don't stop. Yo, yo, not to rap hip-hop, you must know the culture, the five elements, DJ and MC and breaking rap, and the knowledge through the math. It started back in the days before the corporate record exists. I might say this is a dangerous exercise because you're taking it behind your head. There's no such thing as a dangerous exercise if you have properly functioning joints and you're doing the exercise correctly. Not in a cellar, I played it back on the low. I need half of my dough before I do a show in the other half. Before I enter the stage, my patterns go off the page. I rap hip-hop like a disciple of Christ. From the Sarah, the infamous ninth scientist, a leader, never a follower. Yo, 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 yo. I love life, I love hip hop, and it don't stop. A 1-2-1-2, it's lyrics touch your soul. Do 3 sets of rear dumbbell flies, and that'll be it for shoulders, and then move on to biceps. On this planet called Gee, study deadly leaflet pampas on the Ibis style, study by the now, a star child of this shit, taking it back. You want to maintain spinal extension, and you actually want to use your shoulder blades to pull it back. It's not just your arms, guys. So you're going to maintain spinal extension, so your chest is going to be up, your tailbone's going to be up, and you're going to pull through your shoulder blades, and you're going to take your back into further extension as you come up. Some straight bar bicep curls. And I call these like Lee Haney curls because I saw them on this this video he did on YouTube. It's on it was narrated by Tom Platz. It's called Going for the Gold. It's like one of the Olympias. And what he was doing was he was grabbing the bar shoulder width apart, and he was doing curls, right? So he's doing the curls, but he was bringing his elbows up like this, and then instead of coming down normally like this, he would bring it down slightly and he would come back up. I know a lot of people say, oh, it's going to hit your front delt, but you do 3 sets of 12 and tell me if it don't hit your biceps. What I also like to do is, once I fail on those, I like to do some drag curls up. And remember, you don't want to beat repetitions with speed. You have the force velocity curve, so muscles produce force, right? So if you're applying more force than speed, you're going to tax more motor units, and you're going to build more tissue. Instead of just beating repetitions with speed, you're not taxing everything you need to tax when you're doing the reps. The rope hammer curl. So you want to try to maintain spinal extension, you keep your elbows back, and you want to just try to meet these two bones together, and you want to just squeeze it up like this. You don't want to come up like this. It's just this motion right here. And it's going to build all this right through here. When stuff gets harder, squeeze your hands harder. And when you start to fail, you can rotate and find different lines of tension. So maybe instead of bringing it back like this, you can move your elbows out and pull it up through this way. Pull it up through this way. Just keep finding different lines of tension through the motion. All right, so this is my final exercise for biceps and forearms and the delts. So I'm just gonna do reverse curls. I'm just gonna pull up, drag my elbow back just like we did over there on the rope. So I'm gonna squeeze my hands. I'm gonna pull everything up, trying to meet these two bones together. And once I fail, I'm gonna bring it down and I'm gonna do some wrist curls like this. Keep squeezing my hands, and then I'll do a few more reps till failure. Hey guys, thanks for checking out the delts and biceps workout here at Fit Club. If you guys are interested in online coaching, check out www.sethshaw.fit. I also got a clothing line. You click on Slinkomania on that link. We got the mullets and masks, huge and cute. We got tank tops, masks, coffee cups, whatever you guys want. I also have a membership website. This is bodybuilding. It goes over scientific literature, training concepts, exercise library. And thanks for checking it out. I'll see you guys soon.